On behalf of the Barnett family, I would like to express my gratitude to you because you have gathered this evening to remember their loved one, your friend, and Mamie colleague, Rusty Barnett. A passing is why we are gathered this evening. The passing of a man, I believe, of great service to our city, our county, and our wonderful community. In truth, Rusty Barnett had a servant's heart. Proverbs 14, verse 35 would tell us, "The king's favor is toward a servant who acts wisely." Now, I'm sure that over the time that Rusty has served in our community, his decisions might have been questioned. Anyone who leads will find that to be true. But I know that Rusty prayed and thought and considered anything he suggested doing or implemented. I tell you, he was a wise servant. Rusty Barnett was a family man. Everyone knows that. He leaves behind a wonderful family that I know loved and respected him greatly. And I know that you loved him with all your heart, with all you have. Rusty was one of those, I think, rare individuals that was well-liked and loved by most everybody. Always a smile on his face, always willing to stop and speak to you, always willing to be there for those around. Kim said this to me, "Rusty was unwilling to say no to anyone in need, whatever their status in the world." At the time of his passing, Rusty had become our county mayor, and I had several occasions to be able to speak to Rusty. His primary goal was to make Carter County a better place to live. And I believe even through this pandemic that we are facing even today, he was doing the best he could with what was going on, and we should honor and appreciate that from him. I am sure that these past 6 months took the toll on Rusty Barnett, as it has for many of us in our area. But mark my word, Rusty still went to work every day, served the community in his Lord in his best capacity. I believe that Rusty was aware of the most important truth, that life was a gift from God. We all must make a decision what we're going to do with this one life we have. So what did Rusty do with his? Well, I'm not going to go through all of the accolades and all of his accomplishments. You probably know many. But this, I believe, is what he did. He lived in the shadow of the cross of Jesus Christ, his Lord and Savior, and each day he tried to serve him in a better way. This is the most any of us can do in our lifetimes. And Rusty was willing to do so day in and day out. As I prepare to close, I do want to say to Rusty's family, I have had the privilege to know Rusty for over 2 decades. He has always been a humble, respectful, a dear friend, and brother in Christ to me. That was my experience with your loved one. And on a personal note, almost 2 years ago, I too had a heart attack while preaching at Southside. Rusty was there that day. Rusty went out and got on the phone, and he told the rescue personnel they better get there because his preacher needed him. This was a type of servant he was. He was always there in times of need. Luke chapter 12, verse 40. You also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming. He's coming at a time, an hour, when we do not expect him. Mark my words this evening. Rusty Barnett was not caught off guard. He was right with his Maker, Jesus Christ. So please, be sure you are prepared, for the Lord will come back and take his own. Let us bow in prayer. Our Father in heaven, we mourn the death of our loved one, Rusty Barnett. So I ask you, Father, I humbly ask you to comfort his family and friends at this time and for the days before us. May we be encouraged through our happy memories and life of this dear man. May we seek thee each and every day. In Christ's name I pray. Amen.
All you folk, I guess on behalf of the family, we thank you for coming, supporting the family, and not just by your presence, but your prayers and all the good things that have come our way. We appreciate it very, very much. I do want to say to this family, I was telling Mike out there a moment ago, they kind of adopted me 32 years ago or so into the family, from John to Gene to AJ and Rusty and Johnny and Lamont, and gosh, all y'all made me kind of feel part of your family, and that I, for that, I'll be eternally grateful, I guess. I know, or at least I think I know, how hard these moments are for you. My prayer is that the grace of a very gracious God take care of you. And I know He will. He'll give you what's needed. I know Rusty, as Mike said, loved his family. I know that he loved Carter County. For some crazy reason, he even loved being mayor of Carter County. Mike said he had a servant's heart. Anyway, from the smallest to the greatest, he would listen, and he gave. He gave a lot. In fact, just a little while, not very long at all ago, he and Kim come up to the house and brought some of their junk, and it became our junk. They gave. And there's something about the Barnetts. There's something that they just don't throw stuff away, and it just becomes a pile, and I've got some of those piles. But anyway, let me read some scripture, several thousand years old now, but very, very relevant for the day that we live, for the moment that we're in. Ecclesiastes 3, very familiar to everyone, I think. This says, "For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven, time to be born, the time to die, time to plant, the time to pluck up what is planted, time to kill, the time to heal, time to break down, and the time to build up, time to weep, the time to laugh, time to mourn, the time to dance, time to cast away stones, the time to gather stones together, time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing." In that little passage, the writer defined a lot of things, but one of the things that just jumps off the page is the brief and fragile nature of life. He says there's a time to be born, and there's a time to die. Let's begin for a second with the time to be born. For Rusty, it was on a September day in 1955. It's a long time ago, isn't it? 65 years or so. Out over the hospital the other day, Kim and AJ were rubbing his hands, and they were, I don't know if you'll get this or not, but they were saying, "Look at those little sausages," and his fingers, they were saying. And it must have been then that Mama looked and said, "Looked at those little sausages. Look at those little sausages." Time to be born. But there is also, as the writer says, a time to die. And that was Monday, Rusty's time to die. As painful as that is, as hard as that is, there's a whole lot in between. There's 65 years worth in between. For some of us, like me, we met, I think, either on a football field or a baseball field. Long, long time ago, at least 50 years ago, but probably more than that. I know some of y'all went to school with Rusty for 12 years or so. Some of you played ball, of some sort of ball, whether it was just beating the street up with a bat. You played ball with Rusty from Little League to high school, softball, baseball. And Rusty used to talk about those days. And he talked about some meanness during those days, and but he talked about you, some of you during those days. Those are good days. Those are good days to remember. You know, I love what the Bible says about friends and friendships that we make. And some of them, you know, are 50, 60 years old with Rusty. But it says this about friends. It says two are better than one. Amen? Because they have a good return for their labor. If either of them fall down, you got somebody to help you. Pity anyone who falls and has no one to help them up. I've heard several people over the past few days, and Mike just mentioned it, that there were several people that Rusty helped up. But I don't think it's just the last 2 years that he was mayor that he did that. I think it was a lifelong goal. Those were good days. We should remember them. Rejoice in them. He'd want us to remember. They're days of family. I could get lost here, but and I probably will, but bear with me. Like the day you were born, Marcia. That's a good day. It was a good day. I know he wanted to kill you from time to time. It was a good day. It was. Day you were born, Brando. It's a good day. And again, I'm sure that he wanted to skin your head. But it's okay. He loved you guys very much. He did. I can remember you guys there on the baseball field. No one else around. Sometimes it was hot and I would call you and it's crazy. And you'd be out there hitting balls and different things. And I won't tell everybody what our dog done to your duffel bag. And you reminded me at the hospital the other day. Marcia, he loved your cooking. He did. He did. It just, I could go on with that. I'm not. I'm not going to go on with those things. But those were good days. And we should remember them. The Bible says, behold, children are a heritage from the Lord. The fruit of the womb, a reward. Like arrows in the hand of a warrior are the children of one. Blessed is the man who fills his quiver with them. He'll not be put to shame when he speaks with his enemies in the gates. Good days. Good days, we should remember. Day of your guy's birth were good days for Rusty. Good days for you. Just remember. Days of a son, a brother, a brother-in-law. Good days. Remember them. He's a mama's boy. You know that? And he wasn't ashamed of it, is the amazing thing. He was. Listen, he respected and he honored his mom and dad. AJ's told me stories about them beating him to death because he was not as obedient as some of us, well, not me, but some of you. But he wasn't, he just stood and took it, is what she's told me. Just being beat to death, he didn't badmouth them, he just didn't, he respected them. As I've said 1,000 times, he's treated me as if I was his brother, a part of the family. I don't have a whole lot of family, and he just treated me that way. I've eaten way too many vittles with him at Gene's house. Way too many plates of chicken and dumplings. And enjoyed every one of them. We devoured a lot in that little kitchen. But they were good days. Very, very good days. I could tell you some more good days that he spent on behalf of his mom and his dad. I'm not going to. But there were good days. Sometimes selfless things that he did, there were good days. We should remember them because they were good. Then he married you, Kim. Family got remarkably larger, you know. And there were those two were good days. They were. You know, I saw the other night, Sean, how the kids felt about Rusty. I saw how hurt they were. Good days, you know, they are. He thought of a lot of you guys. And, he loved you guys. You know, all those, you know, I can go on. And I don't want to make anyone cry or be sad here. But those are great days. And the reason they make us cry is because now they're memories. And it hurts that that's what they are. Because we miss his presence, his eating vittles or whatever, together. But, you know, there was another day that we should remember. And each of us, I trust, has had that day in our lives. And that is the day we met Jesus Christ as our Savior. I was asking AJ if she could remember the day that he came to know Christ. We suspect it was a little church over Charity Hill Way there. But she being 10 years younger, we can't pin that down. And Lamont was the family historian, and so we don't have that right now. But I know that for many years, that Russ didn't go to church. But when I found out he's going south side with you, Kim, and joined there, I just tell my, it just, joy. That's a good day. Amen. It's a good day. You know, why is that day so important for us, for each of us? To meet Jesus Christ. I'll tell you why it's important. Because this day is coming. There's going to be a day when each of us die. And in order for that day that we die to go smoothly, we need to have not just one birth, but two births. A natural birth and a supernatural birth. In John chapter 3, there's a conversation that goes on between Jesus and this guy named Nicodemus. I've heard preachers say this was the first Nick at night. I won't bore you with it. But he did. He came to Jesus one night. Can I read it for you just for a second? It says there was a Pharisee, a man named Nicodemus, who was a member of the Jewish ruling council. And he came to Jesus at night and he said, "Rabbi, we know you're a teacher who's come from God. No one could perform the signs that you're doing if God weren't with him." And Jesus replied, "Very truly, I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God unless they're born again." Nicodemus was bewildered, and he said, "How can someone be born when they're old? Surely they can't enter a second time into their mother's womb and be born." Jesus answered, "Verily, truly, I say to you, no one can enter the kingdom of God unless they're born of water and of the Spirit. Flesh gives birth to flesh, but the Spirit gives birth to spirit." He said, "Don't be surprised at my saying that you must be born again." And Jesus continued, "For God so loved the world that he gave his one and his only Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life." Let me just ask you, if you had that day yet, the day you met Jesus, listen, there's a time and a season, and for every event under the heavens, there's a time to weep, there's a time to mourn. And for the friends and family of Russ, that's the time. It's our time. If lost a loved one. It hurts. It's time. But it's also a day of comfort. It's a day of comfort because Jesus said, I'm never going to leave you or forsake you. In fact, he said, I'm going to go prepare a place for you. And he said, I'm going to return. Even in the midst of death, if he's our Lord, we have great hope. And he's promised that he wouldn't leave us, that he wouldn't forsake us. Isn't that encouraging news? He who faced death himself and conquered it said, I'll never leave you. Today, he's not left Rusty. He's with Rusty in a place called heaven because Rusty was born the second time. I hope you know Jesus as your Savior. It makes your final day in reality one eternal day with the Lord Jesus Christ. Let's pray. Father, we thank you for putting people in our life that make life better, make this world better, make living better. And Lord, Rusty was one of them. For some, life's been better a few years. For some, it's been better all our lives because of him. And we're grateful. And Lord, we're going to miss him. His family's going to miss him. Lord, they need your help. They need your strength. They need for you to do what only you can do for them, Lord. And we pray and know you will. Take care of them. But thank you for all you do and all you're going to do for them. In Christ's name I pray. Amen.
Family, on behalf of the Elizabethan Fire Department and the City of Elizabethan, we're here for you, whatever you need. If we could, we'd like to close with the fireman's prayer. Will you bow your head, please? When I'm called to duty, God, whenever flames may rage, give me strength to save a life, whatever be its age. Help me to embrace a little child before it is too late, or to save an older person from the horror of that fate. Enable me to be alert and hear the weakest shout, and quickly and efficiently to put the fire out. I want to feel my calling and to give the best in me to guard my every neighbor and protect their property. And if according to your will I have to lose my life, please bless with your protecting hand my children and my wife. Amen.